Today I'm ranking every NBA team's best point guard entering the 2021 season. In an era dominated by the position, the point guard spot remains by far the most deeply talented in the league, so stay tuned to see who's the very best PG at number one. If you're already subscribed, welcome back to D-Flow Hoops. If you're new here and a basketball fan interested in NBA rankings, predictions, and stories, welcome aboard. You came to the right place. Please subscribe and click the bell so you get notified every time I post new content. That's at least twice a week. Kartik Sath earns the commenter shout-out for saying he's most excited to see all the players that are returning from long-term injuries like Wall, Cousins, and Durant. Great answer. The Speaks board resets in 2021 with everyone going back to zero, and 2020's top five get free NBA merchandise. The question for next video shout-out is on its way. Number 30, the Knicks with Elfrid Payton. Maybe Payton hasn't lived up to lottery pick expectations, as the current Knicks starting PG was 2014's 10th overall draft pick. However, Elfrid averaged over 7 assists per game last season, and is still the best point guard on an NBA team, a solid place to be in his young career. Number 29, the Bulls with Kobe White. Chicago let Chris Dunn walk in free agency, which should mean a lot more minutes for the 20-year-old Kobe White. The North Carolina product and 7th overall pick in 2019's NBA draft broke the league record for threes in a single quarter from a rookie last year. His shooting and playmaking give him a ton of potential in the league. Number 28, the Spurs with DeJounte Murray. The last time San Antonio had an all-star point guard, Tony Parker was named to the team in 2014, but TP left the Spurs in 2018. DeJounte Murray's been expected to fill Tony's void ever since, and his development's been a slow but steady process so far. He's improved his scoring in every season and has become a pretty solid defender, so we'll see what DeJounte's fourth year has in store. Number 27, the Magic with Markelle Fultz. Maybe Markelle Fultz is still a monumental bust at the number one pick for Philadelphia, but he's starting to carve out a nice career for himself in North Florida. The Magic traded for Markelle in exchange for Jonathan Simmons and a first-round pick in early 2019, and he averaged career highs across the board last season. Number 26, the Hornets with Devontae Graham. The fact that one of the top candidates for Most Improved Player of the Year is ranked this low just goes to show you how deep this position is. Devontae's rookie campaign proved that he can score the heck out of the basketball. The man was very efficient from behind the arc and is an intriguing young talent. Number 25, the Clippers with Patrick Beverley. He's one of the better point guard defenders in the game and a player who you absolutely hate if he's not on your team, but Beverley's offensive skill set isn't nearly valuable enough for him to place on this list ahead of the rest of these talented PGs. Number 24, the Pelicans with Eric Bledsoe. After being traded from Milwaukee to New Orleans in the Drew Holiday deal, a fresh start with the Pels should be good for mini LeBron. Eric's defense and athleticism may have dropped off, but he still put up around 15 points for the Bucks last year. However, Bledsoe really struggled in the postseason, so he can't rank any higher. Number 23, the Pistons with Derrick Rose. At 32 years of age now, D-Rose still was 4th in the league in bench scoring. Unfortunately, his defensive value is pretty limited at this point, and he's on a losing team in Detroit. Number 22, the Jazz with Mike Conley. Once at the forefront of a big three revolving around Zach Randolph and Marc Gasol, Conley's past his prime with the Utah Jazz at this point. However, he's still one of the most valued leaders and point guard defenders in the NBA. He's also a great three-point shooter. Number 21, the Pacers with Malcolm Brogdon. He should be further up in this ranking, but after joining the 50-40-90 club in 2019, Brogdon's shooting splits drastically fell off this past season in 2020. While he's still pretty good, it's starting to look obvious that the only reason Malcolm had such a great season in 2018-19 was because he was in a contract year. But let's hope he can start living up to the $85 million contract the Pacers gave him in the summer of 2019. Number 20, the Cavaliers with Colin Sexton. If Colin takes another step in his development, then Cleveland could be looking at an all-star player. He very well may average around 25 points per game this season, making him an excellent fantasy player. But Colin's still a tad out of control with his decision-making. Sexton actually has a ton of potential though, because he plays defense, so an intriguing talent for Cavs fans to obsess over this year. Number 19, the Heat with Goran Dragic. Maybe he's building up some mileage as the man's entering his 15th season, but The Dragon's still slithery, explosive, and a great playmaker for a Miami team looking to make up for their recent finals loss in 2021. Number 18, the Thunder with Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. The sky's the limit for OKC's rising wing, as in just his second season, Gilgeous-Alexander's already a 20-point-per-game scorer. He's a silky smooth shot creating artist who's got significantly high two-way upside. Shai's made the playoffs in both of his first two seasons in the league with the Clippers and Thunder, but that should come to an end this year with the Thunder's tanking moves. Number 17, the Lakers with Dennis Schroeder. LA's added a near all-star caliber guard in Schroeder, a talent who can sauce opponents up off the dribble, blow past them on the perimeter, and finish at the rim with sneaky elite strength for his position. His presence handling the basketball takes a ton of pressure off LeBron and makes the Lake show scary. Number 16, the Timberwolves with D'Angelo Russell. 2015's number 2 overall pick, D'Loading, has erased his reputation as a bust and has a chance to break out in Minneapolis this season. He's one of the better shooters off the dribble from beyond the arc in basketball, and only needs to improve on the defensive end to rank any higher on this list. Number 15, the Grizzlies with Ja Morant. The rookie of the year has a chance to take the step into a top 10 point guard in his sophomore season, as Morant's hops and shooting ability are off the charts and make the sky the limit for Memphis's young phenom. Number 14, the Kings with De'Aaron Fox. Swiper the Fox has annually increased his scoring average in each of his three seasons in the league, to the point where last year, the man averaged 21 points and 7 assists on 48% shooting from the field. De'Aaron's the fastest player in the league, and only needs to improve his three-point clip to rank higher. Number 13, the Bucks with Drew Holiday. Holiday joining Milwaukee puts two all-stars around Giannis for the first time in his career. The combination of Drew, Middleton, and Adetokounmpo should be a force to be reckoned with. Drew's a two-time All-NBA defensive player, as he's one of the better point guards in the league on that end. Number 12, the Rockets with John Wall. He still has a lot to prove after tearing his Achilles, but John Wall's looked solid in his new Rocket thread so far. Houston did pretty well in this blockbuster trade, as a change of scenery should be good for the five-time All-Star. Number 11, the Celtics with Kemba Walker. In terms of purely scoring, Cardiac Kemba's top 5 in the NBA at point guard, but this list also takes into account defense and passing, areas in which Walker's lacking in a tad bit. Number 10, the Wizards with Russell Westbrook. Things haven't worked out for Russ in his last two playoff outings with the Thunder and Rockets, but the former MVP is still one of the better two-way guards in basketball. Westbrook's an extremely underrated defender, an elite passer, and at 32 years of age, he's still one of the most explosive talents in the league. Westbrook seems really happy in Washington and is back with his old head coach Scott Brooks. This should be a good fit. Number 9, the Raptors with Kyle Lowry. North Philly's finest has been named to an all-star in every season since 2015. He's led the NBA in charges drawn for two of the last three seasons. He's got a deadly jump shot and has turned around the reputation of the Raptor franchise since his arrival back in 2012. Toronto's made the playoffs in every year since then, and Lowry's been the driving factor behind that. He's getting up there in age, but still averaged around 20 points and 8 assists last season. Number 8, the Nuggets with Jamal Murray. For how he showed up in the postseason, specifically for his performance in the NBA bubble, carrying the Nuggets to back-to-back 3-1 series comebacks, the Blue Arrow earns a top 8 ranking. Superstars raise their production in the playoffs when opposing coaches can game plan to lock down certain players throughout the course of a series, and Jamal Murray averaged about 27 points, 7 assists, on an above-average 50.5% shooting from the field, and get this, 45.3% from distance, and that production led the Nuggets all the way to the West Finals. Number 7, the Hawks with Trae Young. It's no secret that Trae's the worst defensive player in basketball, as he ranked last in defensive real plus minus last year. However, his offense is so deadly, with his three-point range stretching out to nearly half court, that Trae's undoubtedly a top 7 player at this deep position. Number 6, the 76ers with Ben Simmons. Even though he quite literally can't throw a fish in the ocean, the 24-year-old 6'10 Aussie is still one of the better slashers and defenders, not only at the point guard spot, but in the entire NBA. He's an absolute locomotive attacking the basket and has a fairly polished post-up game. If he develops any type of game beyond the top of the key where he can maybe fade away in the post, then he'd easily be top 5 on this list. Number 5, the Suns with Chris Paul. As his tenure in the desert begins, despite being near the end of his NBA lifespan at age 35, CP3 still got a ton left in the tank on both ends of the floor. In the 2020 playoffs, Paul averaged 21-7-5, along with 2 steals. That was on above average efficiency, so he should be great next to Devin Booker and DeAndre Ayton. Number 4, the Nets with Kyrie Irving. Uncle Drew was sidelined with injury for almost all of the 2019-20 campaign, but still has the tightest dribbling ability of anyone in the league. He can sauce anyone up on the perimeter, hit deep range bombs, and is extremely clutch. Number 3, the Mavericks with Luka Doncic. Speaking of clutch, the Slovenian sensation proved he can come through under pressure as well as anyone in basketball. He fought through an ankle injury and had one of the greatest playoff debuts in history. Dallas is in excellent hands for the next decade with Doncic at the helm. Number 2, the Blazers with Damian Lillard. Dame time's as cold as it gets down the stretch. Considering Portland got a lot better this offseason with the pickups of Covington and Jones Jr., we could finally see Lillard lead Portland deep into the postseason, and Lillard's pull-up bombs and his general ability to put the team on his back by dropping one bucket after another might even be good enough to get Portland to the 2021 finals. Number 1, the Warriors with Stephen Curry. You can't forget how good the greatest shooter on planet Earth really is. It may have been easy to let the chef's greatness slip out of your mind after the Dub's 15-win season last year. However, Curry played just 5 games in that 2019-20 season. So if anything, the Warriors dropping to dead last displays how much they miss Steph. His playmaking and shooting opens up a tremendous amount for any caliber player alongside of him. He's individually transcended basketball with his range, and I think Steph will have an insane bounce back year in 2021. For a chance at next video shoutout, comment your top 30 NBA point guards. Stay updated on my channel and the most crucial NBA stories by following me on Instagram and Twitter at DFlowHoops. Links in the description for that. Keep watching some of my recent uploads. This was DFlow. You're the best for sticking around, and I'll see you next video.